one and only, the living legend, Miss Garnetta Rickett.
Yay!
Who gave everybody in quarantine the first thing that they could smile about, and that was your amazing parody cover of the legendary Jolene by Miss Dolly Parton. Hey, Garnetta.
Hi, thank you so much.
Well, first of all, I just love your name.
Oh, thank you. I got it for my birthday.
Was there a Garnetta in your family?
No, my father's name was Garland, and oh, yeah. I just kind of took it from there.
Yeah, very good.
So one of the things, and you don't know this about our show, but one of the things that we're fixated on this show is the song Jolene. We think it's one of the greatest pieces of art ever created. Yeah. So when I came upon your version of it, I was on the floor snort laughing and had not had a good laugh since this all began. Oh, so wow. What was it, Garnetta, that inspired you to grab that song and make it your own?
Well, I have a lot of friends that were complaining about their husbands or boyfriends being home underfoot. And I come from a very musical family, so I sing all the time. And I have most of Dolly Parton's videos on my YouTube favorites.
Right.
And Jolene happens to be one. And I had just listened to it on my favorites, and it just popped into my head. I had a friend of mine once said, "You think different than most folk, don't you?" And I'm like, yeah, that's good or bad. Yeah.
So it's very hard to do.
Being locked down with your significant other, it on paper, like on the Hallmark Channel, it sounds like a romantic getaway, but in reality, not so much.
It's more like the Misery show, the movie. Well, you know, first of all, I'd like to say that it's not it's nothing to me. My mother is 77 and under hospice care at home. So it's just she and I here. So I've been quarantined here, if you will, before quarantine was cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I could give lessons on being quarantined. So I kind of laugh when people are complaining about being home. I get one day out a week till hospice came in with only about a couple hours a week out anyway when the neighbor would stay with mom.
So you're killing this quarantine game because you were already used to it, right?
I know, exactly. Well, but what else do I have to do but take care of mama, first priority, and write parodies? I've written several, actually. So,
I want to talk about that for a minute because that's a hard thing to do. Parodies are very hard to do. It's a really thin line you have to walk on between being just sort of, okay, you're kind of there, to really killing it. And you just killed it with Jolene. How long did that take to write?
5 minutes.
That was it.
And it takes about 5 minutes for all of them. It takes longer to record it because I'm so particular with it.
Yeah.
It took about 5 minutes to write it.
Have you sent it to Dolly in some way?
Dolly would love it.
Now, I have not. Because that's kind of a little pretentious for me. I feel like I had to create a Facebook page just for people messaging me. And I've had a lot of people there tell me that they've sent it to Dolly. I said, the poor woman's gonna have to contact me to leave. They won't leave her alone.
I bet she gets back to you. She seems to be like that sort of a person.
Well, I won't say anything other than this. Out of privacy for her family, I have spoken with a couple family members, and I'll just leave it at that. If you've seen anything about Dolly Parton, the whole family, just amazing people, you know, and she is too. I think she'd get a kick out of it. So I hope she sees it, of course.
Garnetta, did you ever in your wildest dreams when you were a little girl imagine that someday there would be a worldwide pandemic and you would come to Dolly Parton's attention for singing about Jolene in your bathrobe on Facebook?
No, and you know, I try to be such the comedic person that, you know, when I first found out I was going to be seeing you all, I thought I've got to do my hair and figure out what to wear. I'm like, no. I'll really surprise them up with that, you know. So, no, I mean, this has been a blessing and a curse to a lot of people. The thing that has touched me the most, that I get the most emotional about, and I'll try not to, but if I do, I'm ready.
Okay, I got mine too.
Well, I do have a Facebook page called Quarantine Parodies and Such. And a woman named Anita contacted me from Scotland. told me about her 14-year-old autistic son who hasn't been the same in a year. And he saw the parody of Jolene, and he loved it. I don't know why a 14-year-old autistic boy or a 14-year-old boy period would relate.
Yeah, exactly.
It triggered something with Daniel. And she messaged me, and he said he wished he had a friend like me.
Oh,
that touched me so much.
Yeah.
And so this is all private message on Facebook. So I messaged her back, and I said something like, "Hey, Daniel, would you be my new best friend? You know, you seem like a really cool guy. I love you, buddy." She messaged me back and said, "My boy is in tears. Thank you so much." She's jumping up and down saying, "Yes, I'll be your friend." And then I thought, I'm going to video with them. So I videoed Scotland, and they were all so excited. You'd have thought a real celebrity had videoed with them. And she was like, "Daniel, look, it's Scarnetta." And he was like, no, you know. But he did talk to me for a second. And every night he'll have his mom tell me good night. And he hopes I'm doing well, and that he's praying for my mom, who's been really sick. And so those stories like that were worth it. I originally said, Bob and Sherry, that if I could make one person laugh, my job was done. But this goes beyond making people laugh. I've had cancer patients private message me and say, "I can't get out and do a chemo and radiation, and your videos, you know, they uplift me." And I'm just like, wow. So it's turned into something much more than just making people laugh. I mean, it really has.
What you're describing is the redeeming factor in social media, because it can be such a nasty, swampy, awful place where people are either mean to each other or constantly posing and posturing and making other people feel like their lives aren't as awesome. But that kind of connection that you're describing, that transcended culture, country, age, that leapt across the ocean and made a little boy feel like he had a friend in this world. Like, how can you, that justifies every like stupid thing you could say about Facebook or Twitter. Like, right.
I've often said, if I could make one person laugh and still go home early every day, my job is done too. So I know exactly what you mean.
So Garnetta, I have to tell you, the day that we played your song, the Jolene song on the air, before the show started that day, I said, "Bob, I have something that you're going to lose your mind. It's so good. It's so funny." And he said, "What is it?" I'm like, "This lady is in her bathrobe with like bedhead, and she's flat out killing this Jolene parody." And so Bob hadn't seen the video. The first time he encountered it, he'd only heard the song. And halfway through it, he went, "This woman can sing."
Yeah. you've got a voice. I mean,
you really do. Sing.
Well, I've got Mama's wig on. You got to love Mama's always had been fascinated with wigs. So thankfully I found some of those lying around and cleaning things up.
Hey, listen, if you meet Dolly, she's got a few to give you too, I bet.
Yeah. You know, someone asked me what I would say if I saw Dolly. And of course, you know, the comedian in me, the first thing I thought of was, "Hello, Dolly." Yes, hello.
Right.
Everything's a parody now or a song. But, you know, I have amazing people that have joined this group. There's over 1,200 that have joined my Facebook page, Quarantine Parodies and such. And a lot of them are saying, like, you know, "I'm your number one fan and you're good to your fans." And I don't consider them fans. I think that sounds a little, I don't know. I consider that I've made
friends.
1,200 plus new friends.
Yeah.
The word fans just kind of is weird to me. And but I do have about probably 1,200 new Facebook friends requests in 2 weeks. I'm like
That's
the
great.
Cool kid in school all of a sudden, you know?
That's
well, I have a couple questions for you.
Sure.
Here's one. You said that the Jolene parody came to you like in 5 minutes. Do you find, because I know comedians who have told me that sometimes you'll work on a joke and really refine it, but that the really great things, that stroke of brilliance, that just comes to you and it's not effortful. Have you found that to be true in your song?
Yeah, I don't think I'm a genius I mean, it just, like that lady said, you think different, don't you? I come from a very talented, more talented than I am, family, musically inclined family. My mom and her two sisters had a gospel group when they were younger, and they sang on TV. So, but comedy is just, I don't know. It's, I have a very funny family too. You know, I'd made the joke about, I used to say that when somebody gets kind of well known, I'll have my people call your people. I'm like, I don't have people. I don't even have a person. Happy to report that a group out of Toledo, Ohio called Ape Forge, ran by Lisa and Matt, they have graciously volunteered to do PR work for me for free. And I'm amazed and touched. They're a great.
Oh, that's terrific.
That is so cool. And what does your mom make of this? Like, what does your mom think of you making up songs and walking around with one of her old wigs on and all this goofy stuff?
Well, mom, unfortunately, she's had three major strokes within a year and about two or three mini strokes that we know of. So she talks to me and things, but she really wouldn't comprehend this. Right. And I wish that she could. And I don't give up hope that one day that she will. And then she'll message 1,200 plus people. And there, it started on a group, a lady from my hometown. We have about 1,400 people in our small town. And she started.
What is the town again? I don't know if we've.
It's called Vanceburg, Kentucky.
Vanceburg.
It's on the Ohio River, a little sleepy town. Right. And a woman by the name of Jessica Bryant started a group called Quarantine We Got Talent, the official page. And I posted it there. And the last count, somebody asked me, I had to go look it up, was 44,000 shares just on that.
That's great.
So, I have the YouTube channel, which is G Rickett, capital G, and then capital R-I-C-K-E-T-T. And Jolene hit 10,000 views this morning.
All right.
That means that I have 10,000 people that hopefully have laughed. And that's when the other parodies are also, it's easier to find on the G Rickett YouTube. There's several that I've written, but the Jolene, I also did another Dolly Parton 9 to 5. It changed it to eating. I'm eating 9 to 5.
We'll have to play that one on the show next.
People really relate to that one. The video is, it's kind of with props, you know, and I'm kind of feeding my face as I'm eating. And so just to be able to touch that many people, I never thought Sherry would ever go to Scotland and Ireland and nearly all 50 states. And a lady, her name is Debbie, took a screenshot and she said, Bob and Sherry have posted it on their Facebook page. Now, I lived in North Carolina up near Raleigh for many years. I've heard your show, you know.
Oh, that's awesome.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And I had just moved to Sarasota, Florida prior to my mother getting sick, and I moved back to take care of her. You guys are not new to me.
Yeah. Well, tell everybody again. Tell everybody.
Yeah.
Again,
how can they find you on Facebook and YouTube?
Yeah.
Facebook is Quarantine Parodies and Such. And the YouTube is G, capital G in a space, Rickett, capital R, then all lowercase, I-C-K-E-T-T. Great. And it's just love and laughter. That is a logo that Ape Forge created for me. They have bought a domain for me. They are really plugging me and you guys too. And I was so shocked because the lady in Conway, South Carolina, she showed me a picture of where you'd posted it. Then she private messaged, she said they played it on the air. I'm like, not, you know. Then I saw seeing the comments, you know, I was getting ready and heard it. I said, they played it on the air. How amazing. So thank
our pleasure.
You so much.
Not only did it go out on the air all around the United States, but the Bob and Sherry show is carried on Armed Forces Radio around the world. So give a big shout out to all of our men and women, all of our heroes in uniform who got to hear your song.
Yes. My brother John Sapp is a 22-year Army veteran. And so that's very dear to me. So thank you for reaching out to them. They deserve it. To all of you men and women, I say I love you. Thank you so much for what you do for us every day. You allow me, Bob and Sherry, and all of us here the freedom to do what we do. So
to be silly. Yes.
Well said.
Well, yeah. Garnetta, we're going to play 9 to 5 next on our show. That'll be the next thing we play. And we wish you nothing but continued success. I hope that you stay healthy and safe and that your mom is doing well as well.
I appreciate that. I love you guys. You do amazing work. And thank you for helping me reach out to so many people. You're a true blessing. I really appreciate y'all.
Well, thanks, we're just Bernadette. So glad to have you here. And girl, you look good in your bathrobe and wig.
Thank you, honey. You keep in touch with me now. You let me know when you come get your man. I said in my 9-to-5 video, I said, Jolene needs to come get my refrigerator when she comes and gets my man. So check it out. I would love to have you guys.
All right. Thank you so much. Take care.
Barnetta Rickett. And we'll see you next time on the Bob and Sherry Show.
Appreciate y'all so much. God bless.